In this tutorial, we will look at the three Excel functions for creating random values. We will first look at how to use each of the functions and then look at ways of handling duplicate values. And last, we will look at how to use random values to select items from a list. I use the random functions all the time. I use them for quickly creating test data or creating examples. Sometimes I want lots of data. Thinking of values and entering them manually into thousands of cells would take a long time. Using random functions, I can create thousands of random values in seconds. You can see the three random functions in the IntelliSense: rand, randarray, and randbetween. I will select the rand function. The rand function does not allow any parameters, so I will enter the closing parenthesis and press Ctrl plus Enter. I will copy the formula down using the autofill handle. The rand function generates random numbers from 0 to 1. Because it uses 6 decimal positions, the chance of getting a duplicate value is very unlikely. Random numbers are refreshed every time you enter a value into a cell. They are also refreshed whenever you press the F9 key. To stop the numbers from being refreshed, you need to select and copy the values, then go to Paste, select Paste Special, then select Values, and click on the OK button. Now, let's look at the RANDARRAY function. I want to create an array of random numbers that consists of 5 rows and 4 columns. I want the random numbers to be integers and fall within the range of 1 to 25 inclusive. The RANDARRAY function has 5 available parameters: one for rows, columns, the minimum number, the maximum number, and whether you want integer or decimals. I will enter 5 for the rows, 4 for the columns, 1 for the smallest value, 25 for the largest value, and 1. I will change the last parameter to a 0 for decimals. This gives me values that are still between 1 and 25, but include 5 decimal positions. Chances are much less likely for duplicates using the decimal position option. When I press F9, the values refresh. To stop them from refreshing, I will copy the data, then paste the values back in the same location using Paste Special and selecting Values. Now, let's look at the third random function. I will select RANDBETWEEN. It has 2 parameters, bottom and top. I don't know why the RANDBETWEEN names the parameters bottom and top, while the RANDARRAY uses min and max for the same thing. I want to create a random list of values 1 through 15, so I will enter 1 for the bottom parameter and 15 for the top parameter. I will type the closing parenthesis and then press Ctrl plus Enter. I will copy the formula down using the autofill handle. I will copy the values, then use Paste Special and select Values. There are duplicate values in this list. I can find out how many of them are duplicates by using the COUNTIF function. The function has 2 parameters: range and criteria. I will select the range of values I created with the RANDBETWEEN function. I want the range to use absolute referencing, so I will drag across the range, then press the F4 key. The criteria is the first cell in the range. When I copy the formula down, it will adjust for the change in row. By using the COUNTIF function, you can see that there are 3 8s and 2 13s. To get 15 unique numbers, I will need to use a combination of the SORTBY, SEQUENCE, and RANDARRAY functions. I will start with the SORTBY function. I will use the SEQUENCE function for the SORTBY array parameter. The SEQUENCE function has 4 parameters. I will enter 15 for the number of rows and 1 for the number of columns. I will enter 1 for the starting value. Because I don't want to skip any numbers, I will enter 1 for the step parameter. I will type a closing parenthesis and a comma. I will use the RANDARRAY function for the SORTBY/array parameter. The RANDARRAY's rows parameter must be the same as the SEQUENCE function's rows parameter. I will enter 15 followed by 2 closing parentheses. I will press Ctrl plus Enter. I will copy the values and then paste them back using Paste Special and selecting values. This gets you unique values that are in order by whatever you enter for the SEQUENCE function's step parameter. But what if you want random values that aren't in any particular step sequence? There is another method we can use for producing unique values for such a situation. You can generate more random values than you need using the RANDBETWEEN function, and then extract only the unique values from the list using the UNIQUE function. I will generate a set of random numbers between 1 and 75 using the RANDBETWEEN function. In the list produced, you can see there are 2 24s and 2 48s. I will extract only the unique numbers from the list of random values that the RANDBETWEEN function generated. To do that, I will use the UNIQUE function. The UNIQUE function has 4 parameters. For the array parameter, I will use the cell range K2 through K20. For the by column parameter, I will select false because I want unique row values. For the exactly once parameter, I want to return every distinct item, so I will select false. I will type the closing parentheses and press Ctrl plus Enter. Now, let's look at how you can use random numbers to select items from a list. Let's say that you work for a company that does random drug tests, and they want to randomly select 5 people from the company. I will use the method we previously used for creating unique values, again using 1 for the step. I will copy the values and then paste them back using Paste Special and selecting Values. I will select the data in the two columns. I will click on Data on the Ribbons menu. I will click on the Sort button. I will sort by column B. The five people we want for the drug test are the first five people in the list.